So, what's your name?
Robert Lee Hodge.
I've read about you.
Yeah.
I thought I recognized you for a second. So, are you excited about the charge today?
Yeah, it's neat to see so much visitor participation. I think that's really cool.
Do they do this like every year or some version of it every year?
They do stuff like this, but it's not nearly this big just because of the anniversary of the military.
Yeah. Very cool. So what keeps you reenacting year after year? If you don't mind me asking.
Well, I've done it 32 years.
Yeah.
I think in a lot of ways it's a way to help sometimes. If it's authentic and the environment's right, there's not, you know, ambulances around or water trucks or power lines. You don't have airplanes and stuff like that. You got a good environment.
Yeah.
And you got a big number of guys. It's impressive to see that number. Moving, you know, marching or whatever, crossing the river. We crossed the Potomac. We forded where Lee's army crossed on Thursday morning.
Oh, yeah?
And that was really kind to do. Yeah. It wasn't aiming guns, you know. It was like a different facet of soldier life, which was very authentic and a little bit challenging, too.
I bet.
Shooting live rounds at targets to understand what that sounded like. And the challenge of trying to be a good shot, and that's more, it's not just reading about it, but it's actually trying to be a shot with the rifle, and to hear the sound of live fire, audio-wise, is a lot more enhancing and understanding what things sounded like.
Yeah, so do you feel it's kind of like your duty to kind of keep the history alive so people don't forget, or?
I'm kind of a consumer of historical product, I guess. I mean, I've always liked this stuff since I was like four, there's a sense of duty to it, but I think you're also a consumer of, you know, history.
Yeah.
And this is what I like to do for fun. I like to read about history. And I think there is something genuine and bona fide about being a volunteer for the federal government at these parks, in Union, blue, or Confederate gray, it doesn't matter. But talking about what transpired, we don't really talk about why, but we talk about how and when and what. And so to connect with kids is kind of, I think, you know, fulfilling, because I was once that kid.
Yeah.
And so I remember the reenactors and living history people at parks that, you know, it was color, it was three-dimensional, they had the stuff, they showed how the musket worked. Mm-hmm. And so you learn about the technology of the time and different things like that.
Well, I'm an American history teacher, and I've actually used Confederates in the Attic.
Okay.
You know, in part in my classes and just talking about reenacting and everything. And
well, so, it's entertaining.
Yeah. So what do you think of the book? Were you happy with it? Or
It's mixed emotions. It's good and bad. I mean, I don't really like to be known for the zaniness. I mean, I didn't quite know it would be in a book just goofing around, like, you know. And I think he kind of stretched things for sensational value.
Yeah.
But I like him, and he's done a lot of good for me. But that doesn't mean it doesn't come with some warts.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's done a lot of good for me. People recognize me, and they want my autograph. Okay. You know, for whatever reason. But it's flattering. I've tried to take the commercialism of Confederates in the Attic and use it for preservation reasons.
That's very nice.
About Tony's book, I'm very happy about is the preservation undertones at times, or even overtones. But I think they're valuable to talk about what we lose as we grow, as we expand, as our population multiplies. We lose historic green space, and that helps the environment. I mean, it's like kind of liberal and conservative kind of mixed together.
Yeah.
The idea of protecting hallowed ground. You know, it would be hard for me to fathom a McDonald's here, but there's multitudes of battles that are even much bigger than this that have McDonald's dead center in them, and Exxon and all that corporate numbing stuff that homogenizes.
Yeah, I always look at General Pickett's buffet over there. It, you know, I brought my students here about a year ago during spring break, and our tour group ended up eating at General Pickett's buffet, and I was like, really?
Yeah.
So, you know.
Last
so
time I ate there was in 77. I kind of want to go back and actually go, but I heard the food's really bad.
It wasn't good. It didn't agree with me at all.
So. But there was a motel next to it called the Home Sweet Home Motel, and that was bulldozed about 10 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
And so, you know, good things can happen. I mean, things can change for the better. Mm-hmm. I do believe in hope.
Yeah.
I do believe that change is okay. And I think more reclamation of the battlefield will take place as long as there's a constituency. You know, you look at this today.
Yeah. Well, this is like encouraging because, you see that many people that are interested enough in coming out. It's great.
Week. That's where you think, you know, you wonder about advocacy, and you see a lot of kids here, so hopefully they take up the torch and try to, I guess I shouldn't say torch about preservation, pick up the baton
of
preservation, and see more land set aside, you know, more land protected for historic green space reasons.
Yeah.
I mean, only 21% of the wilderness was saved up until 20 years ago.
I mean, that's why I teach, is, to keep it all alive, and hopefully I try to encourage all the kids to come out to places like this, you know, and in hopes that they would also want to help in the preservation. So, really quickly, what do you think is the best preserved battlefield that you visited?
The major ones?
Yeah.
I'd say, well, recently the Civil War Trust really kicked in, I would say Shiloh.
Yeah, it was there last year.
Yeah. A lot of threats either, but protected. And then, you know, you have to look at Chickamauga.
Yeah.
Chickamauga's got problems, but Chickamauga's in pretty good shape. Sharpsburg, even though it's not outright owned and feed by the Park Service, a lot of those parcels are supposed to be protected in perpetuity.
Yeah.
So if that's the case, then you have to add in a few of the rest.
Well, I know you got plenty to do, so I'll let you go.
Right.
Thank you so much for your time. I appreciate it.
Sure,
so.
No problem.
Bob Roebuck is my sweetheart's name. He's off to the wars and gone. He's fighting for his nanny dear. His sword is buckled.